What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Today is the 5th of June, 2025, Thursday, late morning, heading to my next service call in Howard Beach, Queens. Howard Beach is part of the borough of Queens in New York City. We have a new residential client that has a Hayward Heat Pro heat pump pool heater that's on the fritz. It's on the fritz. It's not heating the pool water anymore. I'm about 15-minute drive without traffic to the customer's location. Hopefully I'll get some great footage and I can show you how I run a service call. Let's go. And since it's late morning, right now it's 10:45. The chances that we're going to get some pizza from New Park Pizza on Cross Bay Boulevard, chances are phenomenal. You're not going to want to miss this pizza.
Gotcha. So,
there you go.
In there?
Okay.
Okay, very good. Okay. Did they offer to explain through our rates? Okay, $75 trip charge. The labor rate is $275 an hour plus parts. Okay. But I'll let you know before I change anything. So you just opened the pool, you just turned it on, the heater's not working.
It's not working.
Okay.
I mean, the pool's gonna be warmer,
okay. The, that's the power for this?
Yeah, let me call my husband.
Okay.
Sure.
Okay, no problem. Okay, thank you. Thank you. All right, 82. Let's crank this up to 88. Our 410A system. So the condenser fan motor is operational. Pool is 74 degrees. Looks like you got a salt generator on the outlet side of the heater. Then it goes to the pool. There's the pool pump going into the pool filter, going to the pool heater, going to the pool. Two condensing units. Looks like two Goodmans maybe. Or Lux Airs. And there's a beautiful pool. Look at that. Beautiful. All right, I removed the front control cover, which contains the control bezel and the control board. It's connected with that little black set of wires connecting the rear control board bezel to our main control board, which has the connections to all of the sensors and the two contactors. Let's review components down here. This is, like I said, our control board. We have our 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 wire connector from the control bezel to the board. We have a ground wire, and we have our connections to our low pressure switch, high pressure switch, contactors, all that good stuff. Pressure switch, transformer. So this is our primary secondary transformer. Puts out 24 volts across the yellow and the blue wire. This is our pressure switch. It's going to sense pool water pumping running and water flowing through the heater. If it does not sense enough water going through the heater, you're going to get a flow error. You want to check to make sure your pump is on, unrestricted. Make sure you backwashed your filter in a little while. We have two capacitors. One is for our fan. One is for our compressor. Compressor contactor. Condenser fan motor contactor. And our line voltage wiring from below, and we have our two service ports to check our refrigerant levels. Right now we're flashing the three dots on the bottom, the rolling three dots. I don't know if you can see that in the screen, but let's turn on pool. We're going to raise the temperature to, let's do 88, and in a minute we should have our condenser fan motor running. Like I said, we should have it running. Why it's not, it's a great question. All right, our fan is running. No change with our ambient temperature. The compressor is not running. We have that run light illuminated. So let's check to see if we actually have voltage to our contactor for the compressor. And we have 204 volts. So check above. We have nothing. Okay. So now I'm going to carefully remove that wire. and this wire. That is our wiring going as our 24 volts going to our coil. All right, let's get this in there if I can. Get in there, baby. Okay, there's one. Let's check the other. Let's see what we have here. 22 volts. So we're having voltage to our contactor, but it's not pulling it in.
We got a new contactor here. Let's.
Okay. So we're going to install a new contactor right there. It's showing the road. In case you're wondering, I'm laying on the floor. And I have the new contactor already mounted. To the inside electrical compartment with the wires coming out of the top from our top connection. We're gonna try to get, there we go, that went in there easy peasy. There's one. Now let's get the other. I'm laying on the floor and I feel ants crawling on me, by the way. Yep. I'm gonna have to add a line item for ants. For the ants. Oh, you gonna go in there? Oh, I knew you weren't gonna cooperate. Oh yeah, look at that, I got luck. Woo! Yeah, mama. We got lucky. Look at that. All right, our new two-pole contactors installed. Wires on the top, our coil, and our line voltage coming in. That also goes to the other contactor and it goes to the transformer. You see the black and the orange, two thin wires in the back, they're going to the transformer. The ones right behind these two thicker ones, gauge wires, the one, this white one and that black one there, that goes to the other contactor for the fan. So now if we apply power, it should work. Now I still think there's some kind of funky delay here because that fan normally comes on right away.
Okay. H1, 2.2, 88 degrees. Now we wait and see.
We have the dashes. Some kind of a delay status. So we're gonna wait for those dashes to disappear. All right, we're waiting for the time delay. 88, 74.
A couple more minutes, should kick on.
Yeah, I had it on the other night. I was gonna leave it on all night long.
Yeah.
It was at 72, and I came out around 10 o'clock, I see it was at 71. I was like, okay, something's
yeah, something's not wrong. Not,
yeah. I just put it through the pot, I didn't even leave it on all night long. Why waste that electric?
Yeah. I hear you.
See, it has a long delay here, but.
Yeah, I was waiting the other day. I was like, it was a turnaround there. I shut it off, put it back on, everything went back to.
Yeah? Alright, I'd like to see it come on. Like, we'll give it a couple more minutes. If it does turn on, then I'll let you do what you normally do it, but it's just not, it's not normal. That long delay. Normally it's the fan comes on within a few seconds and after 3 to 5 minutes the compressor will kick on. But a lot of bees there. But we'll see. A couple more minutes and then we'll let you do what you normally do to get it to come on.
I think it was always like that because I was just, what's wrong with it?
Yeah.
Patiently waiting.
compressor. There's the compressor.
Yeah, and that I didn't hear every time.
Yep.
This is the first time I heard that.
So let me turn back on my ambient temperature psychrometer. We're 78 degrees in the shade, and that feels nice and cold already, by the way. 67, 66, 65. Yeah, I'm just gonna chill right here. 64, 63. Looks like we're gonna be at 63 degrees. All right, pool temperature. Looks like we're gonna be around 73 degrees. Yep. 72.9, 72.8. Let's do 72.5. We have a jet right here. Oh, that water's cold. Ooh, that water's cold. Let's get this in the jet. We need around 4 degrees. That's in there. We are at 75.4. And outside the pool, yeah, 71. Okay, yeah, right around 4 degrees. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we got ourselves another satisfied, unconditionally residential client. It's a 11:45 here in the great communist state of New York. And since I'm in Howard Beach, you know what time it is.
Time for some New Park pizza.
You love New Park pizza? I guess not. Now, since I know a lot of you will never experience New Park pizza, I'm gonna share with you what I just picked up. You're not gonna find pizza like this anywhere in the world, not even in Naples or Southern Italy. You're not. And it's very close, it's a close second to King Umberto, KU, in Elmont on Meacham and Hempstead Turnpike. On Long Island. Just take a moment and see if you can imagine what that smells like right now in my truck. Okay, I'm done rubbing it in. Enjoy, be well, God bless, stay safe. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we got another outgoing poster. This is gonna be poster number 15 of 150. This one's gonna be addressed to Ted. Ted Cook. So let's figure out where I'm going to put this. Maybe I'll do it on the top. Let's see. To Ted Cook. Now, I know you really can't see that, and that kind of sucks. And I'm just going to sign it. Now, Ted, I don't know if you're watching, but your friend Roger in Greenville, South Carolina, sent me a nice donation, and he asked me to sign the poster to Ted Cook. So it's hard to see it there. I wish I had like a silver pen, a silver or like a nice paint pen would be nice. That would be nice. But Roger is going to frame this and give it to you. Thank you so much for the support.